ladies and gents, this is the moment you waited for.
And now that was cool. Hang on for a great interview and some amazing music from the Hughes Brothers. Here we go. Hey everyone, thank you for joining us today. I am so excited to introduce to you a musical family that I have known for years. My dear friends, the Hughes Brothers. Hey, welcome guys.
Hey Ross, good to see you.
Yeah, good to see you too. How are we doing out there in Branson?
Yeah, Branson. Branson's been a little bit slow lately.
I can imagine.
We got a lot of honey-do list done.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I haven't started on mine yet. I'm slacking. Hey, before we get started, I just wanted to thank you guys so much for taking the time to be with us. A lot of the residents that are going to be watching this, we're going to send this out to all the assistant communities within Sal Management and anybody that wants to see it. But the cool thing is their families are going to watch this as well. And after this, I guarantee they're going to want to come buy tickets and come see you guys. And the rooster.
Yeah, that's my chickens, and I'm out here on my back deck, and they're having fun making noise.
There you go. See, that's what I love about these interviews, because very casual. You guys can be anywhere you want. Why don't you guys introduce yourselves one by one? Tell us your names. Tell us a little bit about yourselves.
We'll just go in order. We'll go in order of age. I'm Marty Hughes. I'm the oldest of the Hughes brothers.
Okay.
Oldest, most well-rounded, shortest brother.
That's right. I'm Jason. I'm the second oldest brother.
Yeah, and I'm Ryan. I'm the fourth oldest brother.
Obviously, we're missing one.
Yeah, who's missing? Tell us who's missing.
Adam. He's in California. He's not currently doing their show with us. And I'm the youngest brother, Andy. Of the five brothers, and I'm the baby of the family, although we do have another brother from adoption. Parents adopted.
You know, that's one of the cool things. I've coming to see your show. Your theater's big. It's a big theater, and you have your whole family running it and all this stuff, and we get to meet everybody, the adopted kids, the grandkids, the kids, mom.
Yeah.
So they're running this theater, right?
Yeah, there. mom's still here working as the CEO.
Yep. So speaking of that, tell us how you guys got started when you were kids and where you're from.
We're from Taylorsville, Utah. We were out there for 20 so years. I personally only 17 years because I was born in that house in a sense. Yeah, we moved out here in 95, and we've been here ever since.
And I think it's treated you guys pretty well.
Yeah, it's been a huge blessing, actually.
Yeah. We actually have been performing together for, 48 years, I think? And
you mean 40
we started
years.
Out with...
You mean 38 years.
40.
No, it'd be
40.
It's different for every brother because...
They always have to listen.
I started
always right. It's 40. It's 40.
It's 38. 38 years.
40.
I started. Okay, guys. I started
as
when I was three years old.
Yeah, but you were performing with us then.
And then I started performing with Jason. So Jason and I have been performing 48 years. You know, as far as the rest of the brothers, that might not be true.
Right. That's why I said 30 plus years, because I had no
idea.
Yeah. It could be. For the original five brothers, and up until now, it's been 40 years.
Right.
Yeah. So that 40 years ago, we started kind of as a little variety show. We performed with mom and dad just prior to the brothers performing.
Right.
Yeah. And then mom and dad kind of stepped out of the limelight and let us do the everything ourselves, and we got all of the best instruction we could find at the time from different vocal coaches and piano and guitar and bass and drum teachers, and then as we got into the finally got kind of in the high school age, we started to get involved in a lot of musical theater also. So all of the brothers have, among the brothers, we've probably played the leading roles in about 30 different musicals. But that was all before we came to Branson.
Right. So tell me real quick, because I miss Branson. Great area, middle of the country, right there in Missouri. Each of you tell me what is your favorite thing that you enjoy about being in Branson.
I love Branson because of family, faith, and country.
Yeah.
We're very focused on those things. And people come here, you know, we can have our whole family here. So.
Very good. I agree. That's awesome. Who's next?
Well, I'll go next since I tried to speak up. I would say, I think one of the reasons I love Branson, and I think one of the reasons most people love Branson, is because a lot of people view it as old town home USA. You know, it reminds them of what a small town used to be in America, where God, family, and, you know, country in that order. People come here and they feel at home, and right. They feel secure. They feel like this is what America used to be. And so there's a special spirit here.
Yeah, there is. I miss that. It's a great part of the country. You guys are very lucky to live there.
Thanks.
You bet. Who's next?
Go for it, Ryan. I would just say it's kind of the same thing you know, just the culture around here, the community of people, even the people that come visiting it, there's just people are generally quite nice around here. So you do kind of have that feeling of just the small town and a lot of people, everybody knows who you are, kind of yep. thing. So it's a great community.
It is. All right, Jason, what about you?
No, well, there's very little not to like about Branson. Branson is, it just is a wonderful feeling here. And we try to explain it by saying, you know, that Branson's all about family, God, and country. But it doesn't do justice to what happens out here. It's a place where all kinds of different entertainers have kind of migrated.
We're losing you, Jason.
He must have all his kids online right now.
Maybe, I don't know.
I told my kids to stay offline. I've got to do an interview. Because Jason's frozen right now.
Yeah.
He'll come back in a few minutes. Time.
Well, yeah, I totally understand what Jason's trying to say. There's a feeling here. All of the entertainers are very close. We all the entertainers text each other back and forth, and they're all God-fearing. And and then the military is very revered here. More so than, I mean, I know all of America's towns revere the military, but not like Branson.
Yeah. And I was going to bring that up when you guys started talking about God and country and then the military. I think one of the coolest things about Branson, and all the shows do this, is they pay tribute to our veterans. That's an amazing experience. When you walk into a theater and you're being entertained by a family like yours that is so amazing, and then you guys take time out of your show to pay tribute to those who fought for our freedom, that's a showstopper. Bring tears to my eyes right now, because tell us what you guys do, a little bit of your tribute.
Right now we sing America Beautiful, and we also have been doing a Will Rogers Follies tune called Favorite Son. With it's kind of like a campaign thing where we kind of go with our own, if it's versus Democrats and Republicans. But anyway, we also do a
flag section.
Yeah, we've done flags, we've done military songs, we've done all types of things in the past. we're gearing up to change it again. So
that's good.
Even I don't know what we're going to do sometimes.
It just may happen. I think the cool thing about your show and what I'm seeing happening with the country is you guys know how to bring a crowd together. It doesn't matter where they're from, who they are. You can be a little bit political and joke about it and people laugh. I love how in your show and the shows in Branson, some people get a little bit weird and worried about, should I sing gospel music? No, you guys let it go. You guys, the gospel music in your show and in Branson, that's embraced. And I think that's a really important aspect of Branson, Missouri, is the gospel music out there.
Yeah, the great patriotic section just transfers right into the gospel section in our show.
Yeah.
And it fits really well.
That's cool. Well, you guys, I don't want to keep you too long today. I know you want to share some of your music with us, and we're going to get to that. But before we say goodbye, is there anything you want to share with me, you want to share with my residents, with all the folks out there in these communities, maybe bring some joy to them? Anything I missed? You want to say something?
I want to thank your people that you're sharing this with for all their effort in raising a great generation of people, and also for serving their country, for the veterans out there.
Yeah.
We appreciate you so much.
They will hear that, and thank you so much for saying that.
And I'd like to echo what Andy said, that we so appreciate all of the residents out there, and also anyone else who's watching. We know that this year has been a little rough in just a lot of ways, but really when it comes down to it, we know who's in charge still, even when hard things are happening, and things are gonna be okay.
We're
excited for times to come, and we hope to see any of you in Branson anytime. We'd love to see you.
And amen to that, and God bless all of you folks out there. We hope and pray that everything will be well for you and your families, and we'd love to see you in Branson sometime.
You guys are awesome. Thank you so much. Yep. This is hard. Ross. This is hard, isn't it? Hey, do you want to say something? Am I cutting you off?
Oh, no. Just come to Branson. We'll be here.
Come to Branson. This is a hard time to deal with. Everybody's shut down and all that stuff. What day are you guys open? You have a date that the theater is opening again?
21st.
Yeah, that's the day.
21st of May. My friends watching this video, when you get to Branson, I recommend this show highly. Go see my friends, the Hughes Brothers. I guarantee you won't regret seeing this show. Anyway, you guys, thank you so much for being with us today. We're going to end this with some of your music. You guys, your family, I can't wait to watch it. Once again, thanks for being with us, you guys. Take care.
Thanks, Ross. Appreciate it.
Thanks, Ross. We'll see you.
You bet. Bye-bye.
Bye. Hi, everybody. We hope everybody's doing great out there. We are the Hughes Brothers, and we are here in the Hughes Brothers Theater, hanging out right in front of the stage. And we're going to sing you a song. It's been a little while since we've done this song in the show. Was it how long, guys? 2003, I think, was the last time we did this song.
I remember when we first came to Branson and did it.
Yeah, it's been a while.
It was 25 years ago.
It was 2003, last time in the show. But Jacob's going to join us here on the guitar. William's going to join us on the fiddle. In fact, 2003, last time we did this song, I think you guys, I don't know, might have still been in diapers, maybe. I don't know. But anyway, here's a little Aaron Tippin tune for you.
Now, Daddy, he didn't like trouble, but if it came along, everyone that knew him knew which side that he'd be on. He never was a hero, or this county'd shine a light, but you could always find him standing up for what he thought was right. He'd say, you've got to stand for something, or you'll fall for anything. You've got to be your own man, not a puppet on a string.
never compromise what's right and uphold your family name.
You got to stand for something or you'll fall for anything. Now we might have been better off or owned a bigger house if Daddy done more giving in or a little more backing down. But we always had plenty, just living his advice. Whatever you do today, you'll have to sleep with tonight. He'd say you've got to stand for something or you'll fall for anything. You've got to be your own man, not a puppet on a string. Never compromise what's right and uphold your family name. You've got to stand for something or you'll fall for anything. Now I know that things are different than they were in Daddy's days, but I still believe what makes a man really has unchanged. You've got to stand for something or you'll fall for anything. You've got to be your own man, not a puppet on a string. Never compromise what's right and uphold your family name. You've got to stand for something or you'll fall for anything. You've got to stand for something or you'll fall for anything.
All right. Well, folks, thanks for listening and see you in Branson, hopefully soon. Right here in Branson, Missouri. We are hanging out in the guys' dressing room here at our theater because, well, we're the guys. Now we're going to do you a little more doo-wop with the Hughes with a little Billy Joel. Here we go.
Dum dum dum.
Whoa.
Time.
feels right. I could be wrong. Maybe I've been hoping to hide. I've come this far, and it's more than I hope for. I don't care what consequence it brings. I have been a fool for lesser things. I want you so bad. I think you ought to know that I intend to hold you for the longest time. Whoa.
ladies and gents, this is the moment you waited for.
Whoa!
Been searching in the dark, your sweat soaking through the floor.
Whoa!
Buried in your bones, there's an ache that you can't ignore. Taking your breath, stealing your mind, and all that was real is left behind.
Nobody is coming for you, running at you. It's only this moment, don't care what comes after. Your fever dream, can't you see it getting closer? Just surrender cause you feel the feeling taking over. It's fire, it's freedom, it's flooding open. It's a preacher in a pulpit and you find a full truth. There's something breaking at the brink of every wall that's holding all that you hold.
The Hughes Brothers here at Point Lookout overlooking our beautiful city, Branson. And we're going to sing you one of our favorite hymns, How Great Thou Art.
Oh Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all Thou art, how great Thou art.
forest glades I wander and hear the birds sing sweetly in the trees. When I look down from lofty mountain grandeur and hear the brook and feel the gentle breeze,
then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior,
God, his Son not sparing, sent him to die. I scarce can take it in that on the cross my burden gladly bearing, he bled and died to take away my sin.
My soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Christ shall come with shout of acclamation
and take me home. What joy shall fill my heart? Then I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art.
Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee.
Thanks for joining us, and we hope to see you very, very soon in Branson.